William, thank you for being here. Thank you for donating your time to share your knowledge. By the way, when I was in grad school, Searching for Bobby Fischer was one of the scripts we studied. So, and love it as a film. And obviously, Queen's Gambit is beautiful. And what I'm curious about, and you kind of touched on this a little bit, is how do you see your role as producer, especially as it in regards to kind of influencing the creative and helping to kind of like create a true north for what everybody's working on, and especially in collaboration with Scott Frank?
Yeah, I mean, the creative producer can be kind of an oxymoron, but it's how I have tried to define myself and the way I work. Producing encompasses so many aspects of the process, and it's also kind of different on each project because different projects need different things and different filmmakers have different levels of experience. I certainly enjoy it most when I'm in on it from the ground floor. I have had some experiences where I've been asked to produce something that was already further along at whatever stage, and even to jump in on something that was a couple weeks out from shooting. And I find that much more challenging because so many decisions have already been made that you weren't a party to. So just understanding everybody's intentions is kind of the first step. And then are they realizing those intentions, or are those intentions in fact the right questions that everybody should be asking or not? So to some degree, I've been a generator of projects. I've done a lot of book adaptations. Sometimes spec scripts come to me. I have a certain number of filmmaker relationships that are people that I enjoy working with. And Scott is one of the main ones. I was the studio executive on Dead Again, which was the movie he was writing at Paramount that Kenneth Branagh and Emma Thompson starred in. So we had already made a movie together, and he wrote some on a television series I had done. And he wrote the movie The Interpreter for Sidney Pollack, who was my boss for many, many years. I was running his company for about 12 years. it's nice when you have a history and you have a shorthand. Sometimes it's more of a shotgun marriage. Sometimes I'm involved in choosing the director. I would say that producer-director relationship is a art, and it's a very deep well. You want to have mutual trust. You want to have mutual respect. You want to, of course, understand the vision and support the vision and try to help the filmmaker even articulate the vision or clarify the vision. But you're also responsible to the money and to the time resources that you have. And so there's a tension that is built in to that relationship. And sometimes that tension can lead to conflict, and sometimes that's not a bad thing. I've been on movies where everybody's in love and it's a happy party, and then the movie comes out and there was nothing there, but you all had kind of convinced yourself there was. So I would say there aren't that many rules to it other than, I try to not choose people who I think are going to be assholes.
We do the same thing with DreamAgo.
Yeah. sometimes you don't know until you're standing on the floor. You know?
Exactly. And,
I mean, the hardest thing, of course, is when it's not going well. And the hardest film for me, and I won't say which one it was, but there was like a big, big director who was the writer producer of it. And he had chosen the director. And I was sent to location because the guy who was supposed to produce it wasn't available. And after a couple weeks there, I just realized this guy can't direct, you know, and what do you do? I didn't want to throw him under the bus and rat him out to the studio, you know, and the guy who had chosen him really didn't want to hear it, you know, and so he decided that the smart thing to do would be to blame me for all of the inadequacies of the footage, you know, and sometimes, you know, the producer is
big shoulders.
Yeah, or, you know, your job is to get kind of burned up in the making of the thing, you know, trying to protect everybody else. But I love the writing and I love the post-production. Me, standing on set is something like I have to do, but it's not my favorite part of the job. I really enjoy figuring out story and how to make it work.
And I do.